Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2104, Synchronize Slicers from Different Datasets. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gell, and today's question is not about how to take these two pivot tables that came from one dataset and make the slicer control all those pivot tables. That's not what this is about. That's an easy thing to do. Slicer tools, options, either report connections or slicer connections in the old version, and check that you want this slicer to control all of those pivot tables. Easy, right? This question is about this worksheet where we have two different data sets, and we're going to create a pivot table from this and from this. Now, let me speed up the video while I create these pivot tables. All right, now what you're going to see is I have two pivot tables. This pivot table is created from one data set, and there's a slicer that controls that pivot table. And then I have a second pivot table that's created from a different data set, and a slicer that controls that pivot table. But there's absolutely no way to get this slicer to control both this pivot table and this pivot table that's built from a different data set. All right, but I'm going to show you how to do that today with a macro. Now, this is tricky to do. When the question came in, I said, I don't think you can do it. But I've been working on it and experimenting, and I think I finally got it down. All right, so let's go through this. First off, this is saved as an xlsx file. That's a fine file type, except for it's a horrible file type because it's the only file type that doesn't allow macros. You have to change this from xlsx to xlsm, or all of your work for the rest of the video is going to be thrown out the window. Save as. Change the file type to xlsm, or heck, xlsb. Either one of those will work. That's the one that is broken. So xlsm, and it's the default. Crazy, isn't it? xlsm. Click save. If you've never done macros before, alt T for Tom, M for macro, S for security, and you will be at disable all macros without notification. You need to change that to the second one. That'll allow your macros to work. All right, now we have two slicers. Bet you never knew this, but slicers have names. We're going to go to slicer tools, options, slicer settings, and see, this one is called slicer underscore name, like that. Go to the second one, go to slicer tools options, slicer settings. This one's called slicer underscore name one, not namespace one, name one, two names like that. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to switch over to VBA, alt F11. In VBA, if you've never done VBA before, you're going to have this big gray screen. We're going to have to come here and say view project explorer. In the project explorer, find your file. Mine's called podcast 2104. Open Microsoft Excel Objects, and the sheet where I want this to work is called Dashboard. I'm going to right-click there and say View Code. This code that we're writing cannot go in a module like in a regular macro. This has to be on this worksheet. Open the top left drop-down, Worksheet, and then in the top right drop-down, we're going to say Pivot Table Update. All right, so this is where our code's going to go. Now, I've already pre-baked this code. Let's take a look at the code here in Notepad, and so we're going to have two slicer caches, SC1 and SC2, one slicer item, and then right here, this is where you're going to have to customize it. So my two slicers were called name and name1. All right, you're going to have to put your slicer names in there. Application.screenUpdating equals false, application.EnableEvents equals false, and then slicer cache2, we're going to clear the filter, and then for each item, SI1 in SC1 slicer items, if it's selected, then we're going to make the same item in slicer cache 2 be selected. This is a little loop that will run through however many items happen to be in that slicer. In my case, I have 11 or 12. In your case, you might have more. When we're done with that, turn enable events back on, turn screen updating back on. All right, so we'll take this code, copy this code, and paste it here in the middle of our macro like that. All right, now let's just make sure. I'm going to press Control G. I'm going to ask for is application.enableEvents on or off? So question mark space application.enableEvents, and it's true. If yours comes up as false, then you want to come back up here and say that it's equal to true. So that way you're turning those events on. All right, now here's what's going to happen. So our code should be working here. It's on the right worksheet. We're saved in an xlsm file, and I've turned macros on. And what we're going to see is that when I choose from the left slicer, the slicer cache 1, I'll choose Andy through Della, the other slicer is going to update as well. All right, and even if I would choose just Gloria, it looks like it's working really, really well. Even if I would control click, when I let go of control, they all three will update. But here's the gotcha. There's always a gotcha. This slicer, it has to exist, but you cannot use this slicer. Well, I mean, you can use this slicer, but it's going to confuse the heck out of things, because what's going to happen is I'm going to change this to Hank, and they're going to go back to whatever's in slicer cache 1, because I changed the pivot table on this sheet. Now, in real life, are you going to have two pivot tables on the same sheet? I don't know if you are or if you aren't, all right, but things are going to become a little crazy. Now, let's just take a look at this. First thing I want to do is I'm going to insert a new worksheet, Alt-I-W for insert worksheet, and I'm going to call this a dark cave. You can call it whatever you want, and I'm going to take that dashboard that's not going to work, and I'm going to copy that dashboard and come here to the dark cave and paste it there, and then right-click and hide that sheet so no one ever sees that slicer. And then from here, we should be able to delete it. Nice. All right, and we're going to just check to make sure they're still working. Choose Charlie through Eddie, and they're both still updating. Now, what's happening? The slicer that we can't see, the one that we've hidden away, it's updating as well, but we don't care that it's updating. Now, what if you want to have your things on different sheets? I'll insert a new worksheet here, Alt-I-W, and I'll take one of these pivot tables, maybe the second pivot table, and move it to that other sheet. So, Control-C to copy the pivot table, Control-V to paste the pivot table here, and if I need to have a slicer here, don't insert a slicer from this pivot table. We have to come back to our dashboard, take the slicer that's the controlling slicer, Control-C, make a copy of it, and paste it here, Control-V. All right, now we have no code on this sheet. There's no code on sheet 4, and I was thinking I was going to have to add some code to sheet 4, but here's the beautiful thing. When I change this slicer, what's happening is on the dashboard, that pivot table is updating. Even though that pivot table on that sheet that's not active is updating, they will run the code, and this will update as well. Pretty darn amazing that works. Now, the whole key to this is you can never use the slicer tied to the second pivot table. You have to have the slicer that's tied to the second pivot table, but you cannot use it. You have to use this slicer tied to the first pivot table. All right, but in general, I think this is working fairly well. All right, now, hey, Sal, the person who asked this question, wrote in and said, look, I have a disconnected pivot table, or disconnected slicer in the second pivot table only. So let's just add a new field here called region, east, west. We'll refresh our second pivot table. Cool, and I'll insert a slicer that is disconnected. In other words, it's only in the second data set, not in the first data set. All right, now this is going to be tricky, because when I choose east from here, we're not going to have anybody selected. All right, so the pivot table goes away. I would have to clear this slicer on the left-hand side, and then east remains selected. And now things have gone to hell, right? So you are choosing from a slicer tied to the second data set, and while the second one is updating, the first one is not going to respect that, because it has no idea. There's no region field back in the other field. This is only going to work when you have the same field in both data sets. If you have some other situation like this, then it will not fly. So here's what you're going to have to do. You're going to have to insert that field, the region field, back in your original data set, refresh this pivot table, insert a new slicer that will control that first pivot table. All right, now we have two different slicers now, and because I built them backwards, their names are backwards. This one, slicer region 1, and the one that's going to be the controlling one is called slicer region 2. If I would have planned differently, we would have had a different result, but here we are. Alt F11. I'm going to take a lot of cutting and pasting. I'm going to take those first three lines and paste them, change it to slicer cache 3, slicer cache 4, slicer item 3. I'll initialize slicer cache 3 and slicer cache 4 to be region 2, region 1. Clear the manual filter on SC4, so that was a copy and paste. Take this entire loop here and paste it. There are a lot of places you have to change here. SI3, SC3, and then SC4, SI3, SI3. Don't miss that one. I missed that one. Next, SI3. All right, so now this set of code will hopefully control two sets of slicers. If you had a third set of slicers, you're going to do the same changes I just made, copying and pasting and changing things carefully. And again, now this guy is the one that we will never see. We never want to see that one work because the ones on the pivot table 1 are the controlling ones. So this, we have to copy this, Control C, go to our sheet where we're hiding things away. So Home, Format, Hide and Unhide, unhide that sheet, the dark cave, paste, so it continues to exist. It has to live somewhere, and then once I know it's back there in the dark cave, I can delete it and then hide this sheet here. All right, and so now we should have on our dashboard one set of slicers. We choose Central, they both update. We choose just Flow, they both update. I clear the filter, and Central stays. Well, that's actually good. I'm glad that worked. Clear this filter, and everybody comes back. But these all have to be driving off that first pivot table. What if you have a field in the second data set that's not in your first data set? Then all bets are off. We'll go back to I don't know how to solve that. Well, hey, macros came to the solution today, and macros are amazing and awesome. If you want to learn all about macros, Tracy Sierstad and I have written this great book, Excel 2016 VBA and Macros. Check that out. Click the I in the top right-hand corner. Get to your page where you can buy that book. All right, episode recap. How can you have a slicer drive two pivot tables? If they both came from the data set, it's simple. Slicer, report connections, choose other pivot tables. But if the pivot table came from two data sets, lots of steps. Change xlsx to xlsm. Change your macro security setting. Alt F11 to get to VBA. Control R to display the Project Explorer. Find the worksheet name that contains your first pivot table and slicer. Right click and say View Code. And then insert code for worksheet update. Then, really important, hide that second slicer away on a hidden sheet or far off to the right so no one can ever choose from that slicer. By the way, don't cut that slicer. You have to copy it and paste and then delete the first one in order to get it to work. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.